Welcome, everybody. It's 12:45 a.m. You know what time it is. It's contenders time. Let's do two more boxes. All right. So, let me put this up real quick, like. I might need this, and I might need this. Sweet. Get out of my way. Cool. Business. Put this right here. Am I recording? Indeed, I am.
Hi.
All right. We got one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven, Miller. Choose your weapon wisely. Choose your weapon wisely. I know you didn't ask for it, but I'm going to give it to you anyway. Uncle Jesse's 2 cents. My favorite numbers are the number 3 and the number 7. I'm just saying, you can't go wrong with either one. Number 3 or 7. They're like pretty much the greatest numbers ever. All right, so you say 3 and 4. All right, 1 out of 2 is not bad. 3 and 4. Correct? Were these the two that you wanted, sir? There you go. All right, let's get to rocking. Good luck, Miller. Good luck. Although, you're not going to need it because you're breaking with me, bro. All right. Let's get you a Dak or an Ezekiel. You know, Julie's having so much fun sorting all these contenders. That she can't contain herself over there. She's so excited to get to sort more contenders. So, you know, who are we to deny, you know, a happy woman her desires? So let's get her more contenders. Guys, contenders, full case, go get it. We also have personal boxes available. Go get that before somebody else does and hits a Dak or an Ezekiel. And then you're like, oh no, oh my God, that could have been mine. I hate myself. Why didn't I listen to Uncle Jesse? Why didn't I give Julie more work? Why? Why? And then I'm just going to look at you. I'm like, I don't know, son. You should have listened to me. All right. We should get like a camera overhead, but I'd be kind of difficult with this setup we have here. Guys, we still have that NT full case filler that I drew up on there. If you guys want to get nasty on that, get jiggy with it, as Will Smith used to say. Hey, Julie, do you know if Mario's online?
No, he got off like an hour ago.
You know if he's still awake?
Yeah, he's at Bird Bowl.
Oh, nice. Do you by any chance know what time Gelf will be here? Like what time he's usually here? I don't know about all that one, Bergie. Don't know about all that one. But that is very enticing. I don't know if it's the only way it's gonna feel. Like, what if I become independently wealthy overnight, Bergie, and I decide to buy those teams? Boom. Therefore, that was not the only way it was gonna feel. I went out and bought them. So if somebody buys them, boom, they'll be gone. But you're right. We may just have to do that route. But who knows? Who knows? Who knows? I mean, technically, it is Friday. It is Friday. So, we'll see. I wouldn't do what, Bergie? I mean, there's a lot of things that I wouldn't do. And there's a lot of things I would do. So, I don't know. I don't know how to. I don't know what you're referring to. I mean, if it's something stupid and idiotic and there's a chance that it could harm me, then there's like an 85% chance that I'm going to want to do it. Just because, you know, on account that I'm dumb. And I have a severe addiction to adrenaline. Kind of an adrenaline junkie. But I won't do certain things. Like, I wouldn't, like, bungee jump off a bridge or something. Like, hell no. That's a big-ass rubber band. Like, what the hell do I look like attaching my feet to a giant rubber band and praying that it's going to snap me back up to, you know, the bridge or something? Or I don't think it does that. I think it's just a... I don't know. There's too much going on. I don't trust a rubber band between me and, you know, splattering all over the cement. That's just not cool. I'd much rather jump off a plane and then have the parachute malfunction. At least that way I'll be like, all right, cool. You know what? At least I went. I had proper preparations. You know, I had two parachutes. They both failed. I got some time to think about my life and where it went wrong. As opposed to, holy crap, I'm on a giant rubber band. I'm not even gonna have time to like get the moment to see like your whole life flash before your eyes. You're just your neck's just gonna snap. And I've seen those videos. Those videos are pretty weird. Like seeing guys like having the actual rubber band like actually snap. Oh my god. Oh my god. Or like I saw a video where some guy went and bungee jumped and like the thing didn't snap, but they gave him too much slack, and dude just fell and slammed on the floor, bro. The rubber band didn't even do anything. It just gave him too much. So I think about these things, and I'm like, yeah, no. But you know what? One thing I did not know. Apparently, if you jump off the Golden Gate Bridge and fall down to the water, that will kill you. That's crazy to me. Is the Golden Gate Bridge that high off the water? I think, how long does it take for a human to reach terminal velocity? For you physics geeks. I know you're in here. Bergie, I know you mastered in like physics and all types of other business. You're like almost an astronaut. So when does a human reach terminal velocity? Or is that not even a factor? Would it be the surface tension of the water that'll just shatter my legs?
There's more boxes.
Oh, goddamn.
Full of these. So you can figure out where to put it.
Yeah, just leave it there. Go. That's all base?
Yeah.
Crap. Do you have any lighter fluid?
Base is like contenders should just be one box.
It's ridiculous.
Like,
it's so much. The highest you ever jumped off was a 200-foot cliff. And yeah, don't worry, Miller. We don't ship the base out, bro. Don't worry. No worries. We don't ship the base out. We just give it to Julie and we tell her to sort it to just make her life miserable. But we're putting actually more money in her pocket by her sorting all the base, so. But yeah, we don't ship out the base. Don't worry about it. But dude, How'd you manage that one, Bergie? You jumped off a 200-foot cliff and how did this, what were the dynamics of this thing? Were you like running away for your life? from a drug dealer that you forgot to pay or that you stole from? Or were you like, you know, in the Navy SEALs and you just, you know, took out an insurgent and you had to jump off a cliff that, you know, to your an old mine pit. And you jumped off and it was a 200-foot cliff and you didn't break any bones? Like, what'd you do? Did you just jump off and, like, Geronimo? Like, that's it? Like, that's it? All right, contenders business, in case you didn't know. Here we go. We got our first autograph, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not. For the Cardinals, Brandon Williams. Brandon Williams auto right there for the Cardinals. And we got that. Here we have the base cards. We got some base. 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 And more base. Base cards. Hey, how are you? I surely enjoy seeing all of the base cards. All right. So that was the break, y'all. Well, I know it was filled with water, Bergie, but I'm saying, like, I always, like, I heard somewhere that if you jump off, like, even if it's a 100-foot fall, that's enough to, like, break your foot or something. To, like, break bones. So that's why I'm asking you, how'd you manage to jump off a 200-foot cliff? I know there was water. I know you're not going to jump into a 200-foot pit. That's like straight dirt. Here we go. For the Tennessee Titans, Tajay Sharp, Rookie of the Year contender. There you go. Titans hit. Here we have more base cards. Ooh! This one's a nice one right here. Gold ink signature for Joey Boza. Joey Boza gold ink signature. That's a good one. That is a good one. Here we have a redemption. This is another good one. 2016 playoff contenders rookie ticket. For Carl Joseph. Oh man, there's got to be some heat in here. There's got to be some fire. For the Jaguars, Yannick Ngakoue. There you go. With your funky name. More base cards. Base. Ooh. We got cracked ice business. Cracked ice. Brock Osweiler for the Texans. There you go. A Brock Osweiler cracked ice. And boom. So that is base cards there. Let's continue here. We have base cards. For the New York Jets, Robbie Anderson. Got a Jets hit in there. There you go. We got that. These are base cards here. Well, you did ask for a Cowboys hit. You did ask for a Cowboys hit. And here it is. Jalon Smith, numbered to 99. Not quite the Cowboy we were looking for, but a Cowboy nonetheless. And Cowboys run in pairs. Is that accurate? I don't know, but I'm hoping it is. As far as these boxes are concerned, hoping to get a Dak or a Zeke. It's got to be in here somewhere. Here we go. This is a good one. For the Baltimore Ravens. Ooh, Keenan Reynolds, numbered to 25, rookie roundup, on card auto. I have not seen a card like this. Nice. Very nice card. That is worthy of an instant top load. All right, let's continue. Give me a second, Madhouse. Let me go through this break real quick. For the Packers, we got Blake Martinez, number 249. That's a good one. That's a good one. All right, let me check this DM real quick. Of what, Madhouse? Shot. Check your IM. All right, so these are base cards here. Here we go. For the Eagles, Wendell Smallwood, on card auto. It's numbered to 99. Boom. Boom. This right here, we have Matthew Stafford for the Lions, number to 249. All right, so here we go. These are in there. These are base. All right. Sorry about that, Miller. So here we go with more contenders. All right, let's finish up this break here. Nice. Number to 199, touchdown tandems. Andy Dalton. AJ Green. Here we have more base cards. Base. For the Seattle Seahawks, we have Nick Vannay for the Seahawks. Madhouse, give me a second. Let me finish this break and I'll get back to you, bro. Alright, so these are base cards as well as these. Here we have a Doug Baldwin for the Seahawks, numbered to 249. There you go. Got that right there. Got some more base cards. Base cards. For the Saint, no, what? Well, I lied. They are the Saints. Von Bell, Saints auto. There you go. That's that. Here we have some more base cards. We have another gold ink signature redemption for Yannick Ngakoue. Yannick Ngakoue redemption, and this is our final stack to go through. Good luck, Miller. Let's see if we can get this Dak or this Zeke up out of here. And we have some more base cards here. Base cards. Base cards. And more base cards. It's got to be at least one more auto. Here we go. For the Houston Texans, number to 99 on card auto, Will Fuller. Nasty. Nasty Will Fuller in honor of the Bates. That's a nice card. It's a nice looking card. Contenders is very, very nice. Very nice. And that was the break. All right, so let's do a quick run back of our hitaronis. We have a number to 25, Keenan Reynolds, rookie roundup auto, on card auto at that. We got a Will Fuller to 99 for the Texans. Yannick Ngakoue, gold ink signature redemption. Von Bell, Saints. Nick Vinay, Seahawks. Wendell Smallwood, Eagles to 99. Blake Martinez, Packers to 49. Jalen Smith, Cowboys to 99. Robbie Anderson, Jets. Yannick Ngakoue, Jaguars. Carl Joseph, rookie ticket redemption. Joey Boza, gold ink signature. Tajay Sharp, Titans. And Brandon Williams, Cardinals. So those were the hits. We'll get that out to you, Miller.